Good morning, students. In the last previous class, we have discussed the types of extrinsic semiconductor. So, the semiconductors, extrinsic semiconductors are classified into two types. One is n-type, the other one is p-type. In n-type, we are adding the pentavalent impurities. And in p-type, we are adding the trivalent impurities. Okay. These impurities we are adding in order to increase the electrical conductivity of the semiconductor. Okay. So, and also we have discussed the differences between the n-type semiconductor and p-type semiconductor. So, n-type semiconductor means, just once again I am repeating the differences here. These are the extrinsic semiconductors which are obtained by doping the silicon or doping the pure semiconductors with pentavalent impurities. Whereas p type are the extrinsic semiconductors which are obtained by doping the silicon or germanium, which are the pure semiconductors which are doped with the trivalent impurities. In n-type, okay, here we are doping with pentavalent impurities, and here we are doping with trivalent impurities. Now, here electrons are the majority charge carriers. And holes are the minority charge carriers. Whereas here, electrons are minority charge carriers and holes are majority charge carriers. Okay. And the next difference is that here number of electrons is greater than number of holes. And whereas in this case, in p-type, number of holes is greater than number of electrons. And one more thing here, that here donor level is just below the conduction band. Okay. If you take a conduction band, here this is called as a donor level, which is just below the conduction band. Okay. Or also can call it as a donor energy level. This, okay, here donor energy level is just below the conduction band, whereas here the acceptor level is just above the valency band here. Okay. This is about n-type. In p-type, this is the conduction band and this is the valency band here. Here acceptor level is just, this is the acceptor level. Okay. EA. Okay. Acceptor level is just above the valency band. Okay. Now why we are calling it as a donor and why it is calling it as an acceptor here? Okay. Here, whatever the impurities we are adding, here pentavalent impurities we are adding in n-type. enter, we are adding the pentavalent impurities. Here, the four valence electrons of the phosphorus will form a covalent bond with the neighbor atoms electrons. Okay, remains one free electron. So, which is donating here? Okay. So, for example, if we have too much money, then we will donate. Right? Or we will not donate. So the same thing here. Here, pentavalent impurities are having 5 valence electrons here. Okay. Among 5, 4 of the electrons are forming a covalent bond with the neighbor atoms electrons. And it remains one free electron. Hence, that impurity is called as a donor impurity. It is called as a donor impurities. Donor impurities. Okay. The phosphorus impurity which you are adding in the N type is donating the free electrons. Here, the majority charge gets are electrons here. Okay. So, it is donating here. Whereas in p type, here what type of impurities we are adding? Trivalent means it has 3 valence electrons. Okay. So to form a covalent bond with the neighbor atoms, it should need one more electron. So what it does? It will accept the neighbor atoms electron. Okay. So that's why it is called as an acceptor. Okay, it is called as an acceptor. This is Mudha, you see, no? Bank se loan lete hain, kuch kaam karne ke liye. Okay, same thing here, just I am giving an example. Okay, this trivalent impurity also accepts an electron from the neighbor atom in order to complete the covalent bond. Okay, so that's why it is called as an acceptor impurity. It is called as an acceptor impurities. Okay, so these are the differences. So in today's class I added two to three more points. Okay, extra here. Okay, so you can also note down this one. Okay, here in yesterday's class I have given the 3 points here. And there are two more points are, one is the donor energy level is just below the conduction band, and here acceptor level is just above the valency band. Donor impurities, here the whatever the impurities are here, they are a type of donor, and the whatever the impurities we are adding in this, they are the acceptor type. They are accepting the electron here. Okay, so this is all about the differences between the N type and P type semiconductor, which is very very important in the exam point. Okay, they might ask you for at least for 3 marks also. They might ask you for 3 marks. Write the differences between N type and P type semiconductor. Okay, now we will proceed to the next topic. Before that, some 2 more important notes you have to remember here. So in N type, okay, this is our case in N type. In N type semiconductor, the foreign atoms like pentavalent atoms. Okay. Pentavalent atoms are the impurities here. That's why it is called as a foreign. Okay, we are adding in silicon. Silicon is a pure semiconductor here. Okay, so this is the foreign atom, which is a pentavalent atom which we are adding. Okay, so here it has 5 valence electrons. Among 5, it is sharing the 4 valence electrons with the neighbor atom and remains one. That's why here it is losing one free electron here. Here it is losing one free electron. Hence here the core of the atom, this is the core, behaves as a positive charge. It is behaving as a positive charge and this core is behaving as a negative charge. Similarly, in p-type also, the foreign atom, like trivalent atom which you are adding, so here it has three valence electrons. In order to complete the bonding, covalent bonding, it is accepting the electron from the neighbor atom. Now it is accepting, that means it is becoming a positive here. It is becoming a positive. The core is becoming a positive. Here it is becoming negative. So this is the two point important points, if you remember that in N type and P type. So next we will proceed to the next topic. PN junction. PN junction. What is junction? I think you heard this word junction, like Yukarava junction, Wadi junction. So there are different, many number of junctions are there. They are having some particular. Why we have kept this word junction, especially in railway stations? Why you have kept this junction? Because from all different cities, say from all different parts of the country, which are the trains which are traveling, they will meet at one common point. Say for example, if you take an example of our nearest junction, even this our nearest junction, which is called as a the name which is called as a Vikarabha junction, the other one is which is located in our nearest to the Bidar, which is called as the place which is called as the Khanapur junction. I think you heard this word. That Khanapur junction, where the train comes from Maharashtra, from Nanded, and even from Gulbarga also. From Gulbarga we can travel to the Delhi also. So from all different parts of the country where the trains can pass us. From Vikarabha we can go to the Tamil Nadu also, we can go to the Bangalore also, we can go to the Delhi also, we can go to the Jammu and Kashmir also. So that is the junction we have kept that name. Same here also. So that one common term, one middle point we can say, a midpoint we can say. So in PN junction is nothing but what here? It is a type of semiconductor. It is a conductor, it is a semiconductor. On one side it has P-type semiconductor and the other side it has N-type semiconductor. In between the gap between the P-type and N-type semiconductor, gap is there, that is called as junction. So that's why it is, the name has been kept as a PN junction. PN junction. So So the gap between the p-type semiconductor and the n-type semiconductor, when they are we can say when they are sandwiched, okay. So whatever the gap is there between the n-type and p-type, that is called as junction. So that's why it is become as name as p-n junction. So this type of diode is called as a p-n junction diode. It is called as a p-n junction diode. Okay. Now in this p-n junction, the two important process will occur here. When we are combining the p-n junction, p-type semiconductor and n-type semiconductor, when we are sandwiching them, in this process, the two important process will occur. One is diffusion. Diffusion current, and the other one is drift current. During this process, the two important process will occur. One is called as diffusion current and the other one is called as a drift current. Okay. Now you got to know what is this p-n junction. P-n junction matlab kya? P-n junction matlab kya? जब हम p-type semiconductor और n-type semiconductor को जब हम जोड़ रहे हैं, उनके बीच में जो junction बन रहा, उसी को हम क्या बोल रहे हैं? p-n junction. Okay. तो इस process यहाँ पे क्या हो रहा है? दो important process हो रहे हैं. Okay, when we are combining this p-type semiconductor and n-type semiconductor, during this, the two important processes are occurring here. One is diffusion current, the other one is drift current. So what is this diffusion current? I will tell you. Okay, what is this diffusion current? As you people, you know that p-type semiconductor is an extensive semiconductor. Okay, इसमें majority charge carriers क्या है हमें p-type में? Holes है. Holes are the majority charge carriers here. And in n-type, electrons are the majority charge carriers. Okay, I'm writing it. I'm telling that in p-type, the majority charge carriers are holes and minority charge carriers are electrons. Whereas in n-type, the majority charge carriers are electrons and minority charge carriers are holes. So you know this difference. Okay. Now, when we are combining this p-type and n-type, when we are sandwiching them, so during this process, what happens? The holes will drift to the, they will move to the n type and the electrons will move to the p type. Okay. इस प्रोसेस में यहाँ पे क्या होता है, जितने भी सारे होल्स हैं वो n के तरफ चले जाएंगे. होल्स आर द पॉजिटिव चार्जेस, इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर द negative charge carriers. Okay. So these all the holes which are present in the p type will move towards the n, and the electrons which are the majority charge carriers in n, they will move towards the p type. Okay. So during this process, the whatever the current it generates, okay, the whatever the current it generates, that is what is diffusion current. Diffusion current. Okay. और यहाँ पे थोड़े कुछ इमोबाइल चार्ज कैरियर्स है. Okay. जैसे कि यहाँ पे जो इमोबाइल चार्ज कैरियर्स है, अब यहाँ पे सारे इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इधर आ गए, होल्स इधर आ गए, तो यहाँ पे लेयर बन गया. यहाँ पे नेगेटिव चार्ज का लेयर बन गया और यहाँ पे पॉजिटिव चार्जेस का लेयर बन गया. तो इस लेयर को हम बोलते हैं depletion layer. It is called as depletion layer. Okay. So the ions which are forming, the immobile ions which are in p type and the immobile ions which are in n type, okay, they are producing a current which is called as a drift current, okay. So here this is called as a depletion layer, where a layer of negative charges at one side and a layer of positive charges which are formed at other side, which is called as a depletion layer. Okay. So diffusion current is nothing but what? It is a process in which the holes from the p side will diffuse towards the n, and the electrons from the n side will diffuse towards the p side. So during this process, the current which is generating, that current is called as a diffusion current. That is called as a diffusion current. Okay. And you got on the p-n junction also. Okay. The gap between the p type semiconductor and the n type semiconductor, which is called as a p-n junction. The junction, or you can also define it as a, the junction between the p-type semiconductor and the n-type semiconductor is called as a p-n junction. Okay. So today we will stop here. In the next class, we discuss the what do you mean by this depletion layer, which is also called as a depletion region, and the drift current. Okay. So today we will stop here. In the next class, we will continue the next topic. Thank you.